So my name is Dr. Sean McFate. I'm currently a professor at Georgetown University, the National Defense University in Washington, D.C., and Syracuse University's Maxwell School. I'm also a senior fellow at the Atlantic Council. It is a think tank in Washington, D.C. that looks at transatlantic security issues, is my field. But my background is a bit weird. I began as a paratrooper in the US Army, and then I was a private military contractor globally, with an emphasis in Africa, because that's where most of the conflicts are. I left that after seeing some disturbing things and questioning my life choices, ended up doing, you know, my education, Brown University, Harvard University, and a PhD in London School of Economics. And now I think and write and teach about modern warfare and the future of international relations. And I really enjoyed that. Well, in the last 30 years, we've seen a trend line of warfare becoming privatized, whether it be private security companies like Blackwater or now Wagner Group mercenaries. Today, mercenaries are emerging quietly around the world, and they're being used not just by powerful states like Russia and some would say the United States, but by less powerful but rich states, like Gulf states. We're also seeing the Fortune 500 use them. We're seeing super wealthy people like Carlos Ghosn, the former CEO of Nissan, use them to get out of house arrest. We're seeing them everywhere. And I've been tracking this since I was in the industry many years ago. And my concern is then, as is now, is that the world is increasingly seeing private warfare, which was how most wars were fought, in the Middle Ages and antiquity. We've just forgotten that, and we've forgotten how to fight in that condition. So I'm looking at, what would that look like mid-21st century if it, if ExxonMobil had its own army, or Jeff Bezos had his own island with his own navy. I mean, who knows how that impacts things? Is it fanciful? Maybe. Could it happen? Maybe. Accountability. One of the chief selling points of private military companies and mercenaries is plausible deniability. And the reason they're often hired, whether it be the United States in Iraq or Putin in Ukraine, is because you don't want to have to draft American citizens or Russian citizens to a losing, horrible war. And if there was accountability, that wouldn't be the case. But it just shows you, when you're talking about a democracy or autocracy, mercenaries, private military contractors, whatever you want to call them, allow the circumnavigation of government authority and government accountability to itself, to its people. And this is a key problem, whether it be mercenaries or private military companies. This is our future. People only usually, it's like people at my age, generally only look to the past and the present, and we're not very good at looking in the future. This is a trend that has been around for 20 to 30 years, and it's a trend that will keep on growing. There's nothing that will stop it. International law cannot stop mercenaries. Because even if you had good international law on the books against mercenaries, which we do not, who's going to go into Ukraine or Libya or Yemen and arrest those mercenaries? Not the UN, not Austria, not NATO, not the United States. Nothing will stop this trend. So this is something for the future. What happens when anybody who's rich enough can wage war no matter how petty, just because they can afford it? How will that change international relations, international order? Will states decline? Will there be super billionaires with their own, island states? Will there be mercenaries who take over states like a Praetorian Guard? Everything that we think we know from international relations theory in the last 30 years might look profoundly different in 2050 than, say, 1990. Well, arrogant men will say, it was all a plan. I never failed. Everything I did was wonderful. That's not what my career path was like. Everything I did that I planned to do failed, it felt like. And a lot of the good things that happened to me, I was just open to. And I've had a very interesting, a pinball career, doing many different things as a generalist. And I think that I would encourage you, there are very many ambitious people, and that's good. But if what your life dream doesn't work out, you didn't get to the law firm you wanted, that's okay. There'll be different opportunities if you're open to them. And follow your nose and see where that takes you. That's how I got to where I am. It wasn't a life plan. I had a life plan multiple times. They never worked out. So I was just ultimately humble about what life gives you, and I made the most of it.